time for another beginning. Welcome to the parents. So you say you knew you would make it. You knew she would succeed. You knew that you would be here, and then at graduation, bursting with pride and maybe holding back a tear of relief. So you know this is another beginning, a time of change and renewed growth, of holding on so dearly, while letting go so much. Welcome to the relatives, to the brothers and sisters, the grandmothers, the grandfathers, the uncles, the aunts, the cousins, to those who are here, and to those who cannot be with us today. You know this is another beginning, a coming of new challenges for the senior you've seen grow. Welcome to the friends, the ones who care because of their shared experiences, their hopes, their awarenesses, to those who watch and wonder how it feels to graduate. You know this is another beginning, the excitement of new friends and new places, places not yet seen. Welcome also to the teachers, the ones who care, the ones who share, the ones who expect so much and get it, because these seniors have all that is needed to succeed. You know this is another beginning, from high school to college and the challenge of the world. We call commencement, literally meaning the beginning. Graduation, commencement, another beginning. Time of change and renewed growth, holding on so dearly while letting go so much. A coming of new challenges for the seniors. Excitement of new friends and places not yet seen. From high school to college and the challenge of the world. Parents, relatives, friends, and teachers. I'm a senior, 1991 graduates, Stanton College Preparatory School.
Thank you. assembled together here in this moment, we shall recognize that from your hands come all good things. In the name of Almighty God, whose other name is love. Amen.
Thank you. Child of the Universe by Max Ehrman. Go placidly into the noise and haze and remember what peace there may be in silence. As far as possible, without surrender, be on good terms with all persons. Speak your truth quietly and clearly, and listen to others, even the dull and ignorant. They too have their story. Avoid loud and aggressive persons. They are vexations to the spirit. If you compare yourself with others, you may become bitter or vain, for always there will be greater and lesser persons than yourself. Enjoy your achievements as well as your plans. Keep interested in your own career, however humble. It is a real possession in the changing fortunes of time. Exercise caution in your business affairs, for the world is full of trickery. But let this not blind you to what virtue there is. Many persons strive for high ideals, and everywhere life is full of heroism. Be yourself. Especially do not feign affection. Neither be cynical about love, for in the face of all avidity and disenchantment, it is as perennial as the grass. Nurture strength of spirit to shield you in times of sudden misfortune. But do not distress yourself with imaginings. Many fears are born of fatigue and loneliness. Beyond the wholesome discipline, be gentle with yourself. You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here. And whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God. Whatever you conceive Him to be, and whatever your labors and aspirations, be at peace with your soul. With all its sham, drudgery, and broken dreams, it is still a beautiful world. Be cheerful. Strive to be happy.
Hold your head. silver song of the Oh, God.
goes that music again. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm delighted to be with you today. I want to extend my congratulations to the graduating seniors of Stanton College Preparatory School. Also, my great admiration for the faculty and administration of Stanton. And a word of cheer to the parents, for I know the joy that's in your hearts today as you see your students preparing for graduation. And to all other guests and friends who are here today, good afternoon and welcome to this service of baccalaureate. I have the joy of speaking this afternoon, and this is a joy for a number of reasons. First, because of my admiration for the school, but secondly, because I get to represent this afternoon the many religious leaders, pastors, ministers, priests, and rabbis who have had an influence on you young people through your life, and it's my joy to stand in their place here today and speak to you. You know your life is about to change as you leave the halls of Stanton and go forth to college and to careers and professions. New experiences are awaiting you, larger challenges. Many of you will move. You will go off to school. Many of you will not know Jacksonville again as home. Your traditions, your faith, your values will be tested. Now, I'm not telling you this to frighten you, but only to prepare you for the next stage of your life. Because there comes a time for every person to be fully grown. We must move beyond safety. We must move beyond easy conformity. We must move beyond self-assurance into the risk and the insecurity of determining our future. And that takes courage. And it takes faith. It takes faith in God and faith in oneself and faith in others who will be there to help you along the way. When I was 18, just graduating from high school here in Jacksonville, my parents drove me in the fall to the college I had chosen. It was about 500 miles away. They moved me into the dorm and got me settled as well as they could, and then they left. And I gulped and swallowed, and I felt all alone, and I really was frightened. I felt, for the first time in my life, that I had to make it on my own. No parents there to come home to give me friendly advice, and even advice that I didn't need sometimes. And to make it a little more difficult, the dean of the college, you know how deans are, they called us all the freshmen in and said, I want you to know, I want you to look around, and I want you to realize that not all of you are going to be in that graduating class 4 years from now. And if I wasn't scared already, I surely was after I heard that first address. But you know, within the first couple of months, I made up my mind that I would graduate, regardless of how much effort it took. And also during that first year in my life, I made a professional decision, a decision about what I wanted to do in life. I decided to study for the ministry, which was to mean an additional 3 years of college beyond that four-year degree. I made up my mind to do those things, and I did those. The reason I'm saying this to you today is to illustrate that from time to time, when you stand at the threshold of decision, it takes courage and it takes faith to push out into the unknown, risking failure, but believing in God's blessing and believing in oneself. Now, I think each of you here today, because of all the preparation you've had, I know that you have that courage. And I know that you will have that faith to move forward successfully. I don't much like the word success because to me it sounds like a static word about accomplishments done and over with. And I don't think of life as a finished process. I see it as an ongoing, life-going experience, a process. I like the title of a book that says, Success is a Moving Target. All of us, no matter how old we are or become, are continuing to grow. And we're continuing to become all that we can be. See, the opposite of growth is to be static, to be unchallenged, to be content with the superficial things of life. I hope none of you settle for that, that you have an ongoing love for learning and a love for achieving your life. So I'm here today to celebrate with you the joy of your graduation and the excitement of the next stage of your life and the accomplishments ahead. I want to point you to the future. It's good to be a little frightened about the future. It's better than being overconfident about the future. It's good to know that we can count on help from a good and gracious God to bless us on our journey. And so as you begin your journey beyond high school, beyond the safety of the world you know now, let me raise two questions with you. Two questions I'd like for you to think about as you become travelers on the path to the future and the rest of your life. First, can you think not only about yourself or your achievements, or your successes and gratifications, but will you have the courage to share in a larger reality to think of others? The world is a vast place out there. It will allure you to get as much of everything for yourself as you can. But will you remember others? Others who are not so fortunate? Others not so well off? Others who may have fallen? Others who will need a hand? This quality of life is described in the Bible as compassion. Blessed are those who have compassion on their neighbors, on the world, on the environment, on the earth, on people of different races and religions and ethnic backgrounds. Will you practice compassion? Let me tell you a fact that will influence the rest of your lives. Our country, our great nation, is changing. You know this. It's becoming more and more diverse, religiously, racially, ethnically, than ever before. We are no longer Protestant, Catholic, and Jew, but we are Muslim and Buddhist and Hindu and Christian and Jew and people of even other religions or no religion at all. We are not just black and white, but we are Asians and Hispanics and blacks and American Indians and whites and Amerasians and people of other racial backgrounds as well. We live in America, the land that is big enough and free enough for all. I think the Native Americans had some wisdom we need to recapture as we go forward. For they looked at all of creation and all people as interconnected. They had a saying. They said, with all beings and all things, we are as brothers. Will you remember that you are interconnected with all people of all races, all religions, and all ethnic backgrounds? And if you go out believing that diversity is good, you will become one of the builders and architects of the new society in America, built not on bigotry, not on fear, not on racism, but built on goodwill, on acceptance, on dialogue, on respect, and Donna Love. One of the great professors at the University of Chicago, Martin Marty, says, "One of the great challenges in a world of diverse peoples is to be alert to the validity of meanings that do not arise in your own circle." What I think that means is that we all need to be open, that we can learn from one another, from one another's culture and experience and religion. That means that Christians need to learn something about the suffering of the Jewish people throughout history. That whites need to learn about the struggle of the blacks and learn something of their history and literature and poetry. That Protestants and Catholics need to have more dialogue. That Christians can learn the ways of gentleness and wisdom from the Hindus and the Buddhists. And we can all learn from one another. And so my question to you, living in a diverse society, will you graduates have compassion on your brothers and sisters? There's one more question I'd like for you to think about as you make your journey into the future. This is the second question. Can you move forward in your educational path, into your careers and professions, into business and medicine and all of the wonderful things you want to do in life, into marriage and into family life? Can you do all of those things and not end up taking all the credit for your achievements, but stop to count your blessings, to give thanks for those who helped you along the way, and to remember the invisible hand of God who has made you, you? I'm asking if you can keep the spiritual values, the sense of morality in your life, the inner voice of conscience that guides you now, so that you will always be able to see the bigger picture of what is just and true and right. There is a verse in the Bible from one of the Psalms of David. This is a prayer of David, and he says, "I give you thanks, O Lord, with my whole heart. On the day I called, you answered me, and you increased my strength of soul." Strength of soul. It is God who gives us strength of soul to resist fear, to resist those outer pressures and seductions that can ruin us, to resist greed and pride and selfishness. But it is also God who gives us the strength of soul to stand for those things that are right, to show compassion to those who have fallen, to be humble in attitude about life. Graduates, I'm asking you, if through it all, you will remember to count your blessings and to be spiritually thankful for all that you have received. And so I call you to the courage to go out into the future with faith in the Creator, with confidence in yourself. Go forth to serve a diverse world as a friend of all and an enemy of none. Go forth to create, construct, enhance, and protect the earth. Go forth to bear the burdens of hard work, serious study, careful preparation, to be leaders, to come back and serve on school boards and city councils and in state and federal government. Go forth in the strength of your soul and with compassion. I close with these words from Walt Whitman, from his poem, Passage of India. "Sail forth, austere for the deep waters only, reckless, O soul, exploring, I with thee and thou with me, for we are bound where mariner has not yet dared to go, and we will risk the ship ourselves and all. O my brave soul, O farther, farther sail, O daring joy, but safe, Are they not all the seeds of God? Oh, farther, farther, farther sail. May all your journeys be blessed by the God who will be with you wherever you sail. God bless you.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Richard Sweetser. I am a teacher of physical science in the 8th grade Gifted Academy and Stanton's Teacher of the Year for 1991. Welcome to all this evening. Welcome to the 8th graduation ceremony of Stanton College Preparatory School. There are three important participants in this ceremony tonight. First, the presenters, honored guests and musicians here on stage. Second, the seniors, our graduates, the 114 members of the class of 1991. And third, you, the audience, the parents and guests of the graduates, and their faculty, which includes for the last time for a while Stanton's outstanding 7th grade faculty, which helped launch many of these graduates 6 years ago. On behalf of the Stanton College Preparatory graduates of 1991, we request the cooperation of the audience this evening. Please remain quiet during the awarding of the diplomas. We request that the audience not applaud, shout, or make other noise as the seniors' names are announced and they proceed across the stage. These students have worked hard for 12 years, especially the years at Stanton, and we request that the solemnity of this occasion be respected by all present. We want the name of each graduate to be heard. We want the graduates to be allowed to fully enjoy their moment of recognition as they receive their diploma and cross this stage. So the senior class requests that you please respect all the graduates by holding your enthusiasm and desire to recognize any one graduate until all graduates have received their diplomas. Then, after the last senior has returned to the audience, we ask that you join the Stanton graduating class of 1991 in a rousing round of applause and cheers for all of the graduates. Please rise now for the processional and remain standing for the national anthem and invocation.
pledge to the flag. If you feel so inspired, you may sing along with the national anthem. Shall we pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the
eternal God, as we come in this hour at the call of Stanton College Preparatory School, the students here and their family and their loved ones, they at the door, the inner door, is open. Eternal God, go with them, stand by them, and let them know there is no other way but with thee. Eternal God, when they come to doors, many doors in the world is open, but eternal God, touch their minds, their hearts, and let them know that everything looked good is not good. Eternal God, even their parents and loved ones, they are the youth, adults. They can speak for themselves. But oh, eternal God, be with them and go with them. It's our prayer. Amen.
Good evening, graduating seniors, honored guests, parents, friends of the graduates, and faculty members. It is my pleasure to welcome each of you this evening for the 8th annual commencement exercise of Stanton College Preparatory School. I'd like to introduce Ms. Verna Griffin, assistant principal, who will introduce our platform guests.
At this special time, it is both an honor and a privilege to introduce our special guest. Platform guests are asked to stand and be recognized. Please hold your applause until all guests have been introduced. Dr. Jerry Google, Principal, Stanton College Preparatory School. Mrs. Julianne Blackman, Professor of Communications, FCCJ. Dr. Larry Zinke, Superintendent, Duval County School System. The Honorable Gwen Gibson, Duval County School Board. We are very pleased that she has joined us this evening to honor our guests and present the diplomas. Ms. Linda Lewis, Assistant Vice President for Enrollment, Student Services, University of North Florida, and former principal of Stanton. Dr. Veronica Valentine, Director of Exceptional Education and former principal of Stanton. Dr. Carol Walker, Principal on Special Assignment Desegregation Center and former principal of Stanton. Ms. Mary Brown, Principal James Wallen Johnson Middle Magnet School. On my left, Mr. Levi H. McIntosh Jr., Area 5 Superintendent. Dr. John Kennedy, Assistant Superintendent for Educational Services. Reverend Curtis Paris, grandfather of a graduate. Mr. Richard Sweetser, Stanton Teacher of the Year, 1991. Mr. Kenneth Krauss, valedictorian for the senior class, 1991. Mr. Andy Howell, valedictorian for the senior class of 1991. Ms. Jennifer Anderson, president of the senior class, 1991. On our back row to my right, Mr. Arthur Roberts, vice principal. Ms. Sally Roberts, assistant principal for student services. Mr. Haley Howard Jr., assistant principal for student services. Mr. Dan Moody, assistant principal for community education. Mr. Bob Turba, department leader for guidance. Mrs. Jerry Lee, department leader for fine arts. Mr. Steve Durant, chairman of our Stanton LSAC. Ms. Linnell Cruz, president of the Stanton PTSA. On my left, back row, Ms. Johanna Dixon, Mr. Jim Smith, Stanton Choral Director, Mr. Scott Yurka, Westside Baptist Church, Mr. Alan Rushing, Senior Class Sponsor, Mr. Kim Anderson, Special Guest, Mrs. Glenda Davis, President of Choral Boosters, Mr. Jim Sparks, President of Athletic Boosters, Ms. Julia Powell, President of Band Boosters. Please give them a round of applause. To the parents of these graduates, would you please stand and allow the graduates to recognize you for the love and support you have given them throughout their lives. Parents, will you please stand?
Ladies and gentlemen, the introductions of this evening would not be complete without recognizing those who have been so much a part of these graduates' lives for the past years. It is with a great deal of pride that we recognize the outstanding Stanton College Preparatory faculty and staff. Would they stand, please? Let's give them a round.
Of 1991. He had maintained a 3.98 non-weighted GPA and a 4.62 weighted GPA. Just a few of his accomplishments are National Merit Scholar, member of the National Honor Society, member of the Brain Brawl Team, member of Mu Alpha Theta Math Honor Society Math Team. He played many sports outside of school, baseball, football, and basketball, just to mention a few. And he attended a National Young Leaders Conference in Washington, D.C. last summer. Please welcome Andy Howell. Andy was accepted to Yale University and will be attending the Honors Program at University of Florida this fall on a valedictorian and National Merit Scholarship.
See, this is my speech isn't exactly the way it was prepared, and so I've kind of been frantically rewriting it all day. So forgive me if it's kind of choppy or kind of sounds kind of pieced together, because it is. It was tough trying to rewrite all this stuff today and get everything done, but all the members of a senior class really stood behind me. And you've been through a lot of tough times together. And I think all of you know that you've been here since seventh grade. You've spent nearly 10,000 hours here standing. That's 10,000 hours that we're just leaving behind now. It's all over. You leave behind all those hours of signing yearbooks, sitting around, talking at comms time, just having fun at lunch. We leave all those pep rallies, bonfires, dances, after-school activities, and clubs. We'll miss all those first days of school when we could see our friends for the first time in months and talk about what we did over the summer, compare our schedules, meet new teachers. Next year, when we're sitting in a class, maybe 200, and in a college, and we're lost, where there's maybe 30,000 people, and a professor is up there that doesn't really know us, and maybe he doesn't care to. We'll appreciate a little more the first day of our senior year at Stanton, when we had 25 people in the class, and they were all good friends, including the teacher. Sure, classes at Stanton were hard, but we won't remember that. We won't remember all the facts we learned, like who's the third ruler of the Holy Roman Empire, or the stages in the Krebs cycle. We'll remember all the good times we had. We'll remember our friends, because that's the real reason we're all here. We all came to Stanton for different reasons, but we all stayed for each other. Many people went back to their local high schools to make better grades, to be ranked higher, or to have less work. Those of us that stayed found something here. A common interest bound us together, and this bond grew every year. Every year, we grew up a little more, and we got a little closer together. In many ways, Stanton is like a second family. This family watched us grow, taught us everything it knew, and gave us a lot of fun on the way. And just now, when we're learning to appreciate it, it sends us off to college. Even the teachers are a part of this family. There's not a teacher here that we can't talk to about our problems. Mr. Rushing, for example, he may give you the hardest test you've ever seen, but he's always there before school to help you. Mr. Hoffman or Ms. Madison may give you tests that give you nightmares for weeks. If you have trouble, they'll always be there to help you one-on-one after school. I use those teachers as examples because I know them well. But all of our teachers had the same attitude towards us. Their dedication has paid off because they changed our lives. Take Mr. Johnson and Mr. Fancio, for example. Seriously. They got a lot of headaches and put in a lot of extra time and effort into chaperoning 10 rowdy kids to LA for the academic decathlon team. They cared enough to take the time. I'm glad they cared enough to take the time, because on that trip, I learned the secret to standing. Take a bunch of kids, some that know each other, some that don't, throw them together with some dedicated teachers. Then through all the stress and hard work, they become inseparable friends, and they have memories that will last a lifetime. But now, there are no more trips to LA, no more junior-senior football games, no more powder puff games. No more crew races, no more parties at you-know-who's house. No more hiding alarm clocks in Mr. Rushing's overhead projector. No more flushing M80s down the toilet and watching all the pipes explode. My dad taught me that. No more waiting in the crib. And no more throwing me in the pool. Not funny. I'll miss all of those things. Most of all, I'll miss just sitting in the class, surrounded by my friends, just watching everyone. Watching and thinking about all the great things we've done, always planning to do more. We all talked about wanting to graduate, but I think the fun is in getting here. Now it's here so fast, and there's still so many things I want to do. Seniors, take a look around you. Take a good look. This is the last time you'll see some of these people. This group will never be fully assembled again. We'll all go our own separate ways, but I won't forget how I got here. I was given knowledge, potential, and memories at Stanton, and it was hard a lot of times. We all had tests and essays and things that just seemed like we'd never make it through. But I won't remember, I mean, I won't forget that, like everyone else, I survived all the tough times, hard work, and had a little fun because I got by with a little help from my friends. Thank you all. Good evening. As class salutatorian, it is my honor to introduce tonight's keynote speaker. This is Julianne McIntosh Blackman. One of the traditions at Stanton since its inception has been the philosophy of teachers who help and teachers who care. These two phrases describe our guest speaker perfectly. Currently professor of communications at Florida Community College, Mrs. Blackman holds a Bachelor of Arts degree from Bethune-Cookman College and a master's degree from Pepperdine University. She has held teaching positions in New York, South Carolina, California, in addition to a number of positions in the Duval County Public School System. Prior to accepting her position at FCCJ, Mrs. Blackman taught research and speech at Stanton. It was by virtue of this position that we came to know her. To say she touched our lives is an understatement. While we were saddened to see her leave Stanton, we shared her pride and excitement with reference to her new assignment. Tonight, we are honored to welcome her back as our commencement speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming our guest speaker, Mrs. Julianne.
Thank you, Kenneth, for such a gracious introduction. If I didn't know me, I'd be impressed. And thank you for such a warm reception. All that I can say now is that I know how the toast feels after receiving the butter and the jam. Real good. The great Bishop Fulton Sheen said, "Applause sums up the highest of virtues. To applaud as you just did at the beginning of a speech is an act of faith. If perchance you applaud during the middle of my speech, that is an act of hope. But if you applaud at the end of this speech, that is an act of charity. And I do hope you're in a charitable mood tonight." To the honorable school board members who demonstrate leadership and foresight at the helm of this great academic sphere, Dr. Zinke, diplomat, innovator, dedicated educator, who plans for the future of this exemplary school district, keeping a delicate balance between the best of what's new while not forgetting the excellence of the past. Mr. McIntosh, Area Assistant Superintendent, the Tower of Strength in Area 5, who leads with dynamic action, leadership, integrity, and tenacity. Other district administrators who demonstrate tact, fortitude, and special proficiencies, whether planning the implementation or implementing the plan. Two former principals, Walker, Valentine, and Lewis, who ostentatiously represented wisdom and insight during each tenure. The other phenomenal platform guests, which includes civic, communal, ecumenical, governmental, professional, and parental representatives of the school and community, to the parents and guardians of the graduates who have faithfully, amazingly, sometimes painfully, but always lovingly stood through it all. Other reverent relatives, noble neighbors, favorite friends, significant others included, Principal Google, who daily promotes and reflects character, initiative, and intelligence, other Stanton administrators and staff who require a diversity of qualities paramount are understanding and expertise, to the competent, imaginative, and compassionate teachers seated throughout this auditorium who have nurtured, extolled, instilled, and inspired all while instructing. And to the unabated, uncanny, unequivocal, unexcelled 1991 Sterling graduates of graduates of Stanton College Preparatory School, 114 strong, who know beyond a shadow of a doubt that what they have achieved tonight is a definite two snaps up. An S formation. Good evening. I was conversing with a colleague the other day who inquired about the significance of this class to me. Just why are they so special? What do they mean to you? During the inquiry, my eye caught sight of her watch, and I said, you know, that class to me is like your Rolex watch. Pure gold, open face, timely, dependable, always busy, and just full of good works. After that, there were no further questions. However, my initial introduction to this class came about the same time of year 2 years ago when this class was the sophomore class. One day, a very effervescent and inquisitive young man stopped me in the hall and asked, are you that new research teacher? I said, I am. Well, he said, we hear you're a heck of a teacher and we are ready for you next year. Needless to say, I did not know how to process that warning, so I accepted it at face value. During the fall of 1989, I was completely armed for them. I was ready, thanks to the warning. But that was then, and this is now. And this moment, I could never really be prepared enough for. Henry Adams expresses it best in his autobiography when he says, a teacher affects eternity. He never knows where his influence will stop. The thought that what I do in the classroom may have implications weeks, months, and even years later in the lives of students is very sobering, and it carries a real and very heavy responsibility. But I accepted that responsibility willingly and gladly almost 20 years ago, working towards inspiring students and exerting an influence that will, as Henry Adams stated, affect eternity. It is a glorious day. It is your graduation day. But I too am honored because you, whose lives I touched for a short while, requested that I share in this last special moment with you as your commencement speaker. I have have experienced many grand and glorious moments in my career, but this is the epitome. This is the top of the mountain, and oh, what a view. You have just completed the last milestone on a long path, and please know that you have made an excellent beginning, because now you face the mountain. So I'll tell you, like my parents often indicated to me, that if you don't climb the mountain, you can't see the view. If you don't climb the mountain, you can't see the view. When our daughter was in preschool, she became so excited one day because she had learned how to spell a new word, and her new word was mama. When I arrived to pick her up, she ran and embraced me so lovingly and warmly and said, "Mama, mama, I can spell mama." I said, "Okay, baby, wait until we get home. Spell it when we get home." We got in the car and she was buckled into the seat, and my eye caught her eye in the rearview mirror, and she was fidgeting and saying, she said, "Mama, mama, but I can spell mama." I said, "Okay, baby, wait until we get home, then you can spell it." As soon as we got home, I went into the house and she tugged and pulled and said, "Mama, mama, I can spell mama." I said, "Okay, baby, spell mama." She smiled from ear to ear and she looked up at me and she folded her hands and she said, "Mama, mama." She looked at the floor and she said, "Mama, mama, D, mama, D, O." And she spun around and she started again. "Mama, D, O, G, mama." A loving mother say, but that's great, dear mama. But let me report. She spells mama correctly now. The meaning may not have changed, but it is spelled correctly. Some of you probably wanted to spell research teacher the same way our daughter originally spelled mama. No comments. But actually, research teacher, or Mount Blackmon, was just the small mountain that you face. The first significant mountain I faced, at least what I thought was significant, was over 20 years at Stanton also. She was called Mount Vera Canty Wiles in English. And the irony of it all is that I'm often told I replicate her style. Many of you who entered Stanton 6 years ago, remember, feared Mount Elnora Atkins. But you later realized that she only represented the discipline you needed. Some of you acquired early on Jack Shaw phobia. Only to realize that it was a needless fear. Some feared Mount Prime and Mount Madison, but later found that there was no equation you couldn't solve. Some thought that Mount Shreve and Mount Piscatelli were impossible and wanted to give up. You even thought Mount Butler was out of the question in biology. You even thought that Mount Renfrew would never be conquered, but now, analyzing the literary greats has become perhaps one of your favorite pastimes. Because you held on, because you kept your grip. When you succeeded, you realized those seemingly difficult mountains gave a tremendous view, and graduates, there are bigger mountains awaiting you outside of Stanton's halls. They are the institutional, career, and lifelong mountains, and whether this first mountain that you encounter is labeled MIT, USC, or the Naval Academy, FCCJ, UNF, or UF, FAMU, FSU, or Princeton U, Yale, or Hinsdale, Morehouse, or you stay home and work from your house, if you don't climb the mountain, you can't see the view. In the story, Alice in Wonderland, Alice asked the Cheshire Cat, Would you tell me, please, which way I ought to walk from here? The Cheshire Cat responded, "That, my dear, depends a good deal on where you want to get to. In Madrid, many relics of Spain's greatest queen, Queen Isabella, can be seen. The motto on her coat of arms one time read, 'Ne plus ultra,' meaning nothing further, which described Spain's geographical position jutting out into the Atlantic Ocean. But when Christopher Columbus returned and reported his findings, Isabella had the old motto repainted. The knee, N-E, was removed. Today, the motto reads, 'Plus ultra, something further.' There is more, graduates. What lies, Father? The essence of your education, to serve humankind. Sophocles answered a plea when he wrote, 'Look upon Oedipus, this is the king who solved the famous riddle and towered up most powerful of men. No mortal eyes look on him with envy.' Sophocles also said that it is better to be dead than not be aware of humankind's needs. And this evening, I want to add that it is better to not be aware of humankind's needs than not to act. To become, in John Donne's elegant phrase, involved in mankind. That means first the person to your right, then to your left, then the city, the state, the country to the east, to the west, to the north, and to the south, to try and resolve future wars, to keep the democratic process clean, to seek cures for the diseased, educate the illiterate, and remove putrefaction from the environment. Whatever you do, wherever you go, make humankind's problems your mountains. For if you don't climb the mountain, you can't see the view. You can't solve the problems. King Saul. King Saul thought that Goliath was too big to fight. But David, oh David, David thought Goliath was too big to miss. Think like David. Think that mountain is too big to miss climbing it. In climbing, I recommend that you take three tools with you. First, pride. Second, a positive mental attitude. And third, determination. First, when you have pride, you'll be like the American industrial arts teacher who drove to the Kennedy Airport to meet his Russian counterpart. As part of a cultural exchange program, the American teacher was to show the Russian industrial arts instructor around the city of New York. As they drove past one huge office building, the Russian asked, "How long it take to put up that building?" "Oh, about 8 months," answered the American. "In Russia, we do it in 4 months." Then they passed a multi-story apartment building. The Russian teacher again asked, "How long that take to go up?" "I think that took about 3 months," the American teacher replied. It took about 6 months," the American teacher replied. "In Russia, it takes 3 months." Then that moment, they passed the phenomenal World Trade Center. The American teacher quickly said, "Gee, that's odd. That wasn't up there this morning when I passed by." You are justified, graduates. You're justified in the pride you have in finishing this great school. Through the accomplishments and frustrations, triumphs and tragedies, and tears and laughter, Stanton has eminently prepared you to face tomorrow. Second, on your time up, you will need a positive mental attitude, one like the little boy had who was overheard talking to himself when he was going out to play with his baseball and bat. With his little cap on backwards, he said to himself, "I am the greatest hitter in the world." He tossed the ball into the air, swung at it, and he missed. Strike one. He tossed the ball into the air again and he said, "I am the greatest hitter in the world." Swung at it, he missed again. Strike two. Undaunted,
He picked the ball up, he examined the ball, then the bat, and the third time he threw the ball again, he said, "I'm the greatest hitter who ever lived." He swung the bat with all his might. He missed a third time. He cried out though, "Wow, strike three. What a pitcher. I'm the greatest pitcher in the world." Positive mental attitude. The third important tool that you'll need on your climb up is determination. And Langston Hughes says it best in his poem, Mother to Son. "Well, son, I'll tell you, life for me ain't been no crystal stair. It's had tacks in it and splinters and boards torn up and places with no carpet on the floor bare. But all the time, I's been a-climbing, honey. I've been turning corners and reaching landings and sometimes going in the dark where there ain't been no light. So don't you set down. Don't you set down on the stairs, 'cause you find it's kinda hard. Don't you fall now, 'cause I's still climbing. And life for me ain't been no crystal stair." Now that translates into modern day language, graduates, that if you don't climb the mountain, you can't see the view. Graduates, the entire world is waiting on you. Whatever your preference for mountains, the list is overflowing. We are waiting for you to be the strength in the struggle, to be the solution for the problem. You see, Toro and Bridget, it's important that you understand that the best lawyer has not litigated yet. Joy, the best orator has not spoken. Michael, the best physicist, has yet to emerge. Antoinette, Melody, and Earlene, the best physicians have not operated yet. Jason, the best advertiser, has yet to emphasize desirable qualities enough as to arouse a desire to buy or patronize. Marguerite, Shakespeare's writings are still awaiting competition. Katrina and Michelle, whatever your route to enhance the conveying of information, you are needed to make the field of communications that much better. Chad, Lee Iacocca needs help in maintaining Chrysler. Phoebe, the environment is in dire need. Angelitha, pharmacology needs the superior input that only you can give. Jennifer, the architect who designed the World Trade Center will only be considered mediocre one day. And Andy, autonomous is being redefined because of you. And graduates, the list is endless. The list goes on. But my time isn't endless, so I'll just say, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. What has been done in the past is just that, past. What will happen in the future from this day forward depends on you. I find it interesting that on June 4th, 1780, exactly 211 years ago today, in Hartford, Connecticut, there was an eclipse of the sun so that even at noon it looked like midnight. In that day, more religious than today, many thought that it was the end of the world, that Judgment Day had arrived. In the House of Delegates, many frightened legislators in panic motioned for adjournment, but the Speaker of the House, Colonel Davenport, voted down the motion and silenced the commotion with the words, "Gentlemen, gentlemen, gentlemen of the House, the day of judgment has either come or it has not come. If it has not come, there's no need to adjourn. But if it has come, all I want is for the Lord to find me doing my duty. I therefore will entertain the motion that candles be brought into this chamber to enlighten this hall of democracy." Graduates, take the candles that you have been given to enlighten your lives and be found doing your best Be found developing your minds. Be found having positive experiences. Be found helping humankind. For if you make that attempt, or if you don't make that attempt, if you don't climb the mountain, you won't see the view. To the unabated, uncanny, unequivocal, unexcelled 1991 class of Stanton College Preparatory School, may your climb up the mountain be straight and true. And may your destination be golden with happiness and alive with vibrant promise. Congratulations. I love you. God bless each of you.
To our honored graduates. Seniors, please rise. Dr. Zinke, would you come forward, please? Dr. Zinke, I'd like to present to you the 8th graduating class of Stanton College Preparatory School. Stanton is proud of this class, and I'd like to point out some of their accomplishments. First place, County Senior Math Field Day out of 15 competing public schools. Superior at District and State Thespian Festivals. All-State Chorus, All-State Band, State and National Art Awards, State and National Foreign Language Awards, numerous math competition awards, National Recognized Cheerleader Squad. The highest number of Florida Academic Scholars Fund Awards in the state of Florida. The highest number of students receiving awards at the District History Fair Competition, Regional and State Science Fair Competition. Also, Dr. Zinke, Mr. McIntosh, Area 5 Superintendent, would like to point out some additional accomplishments of this outstanding class.
Dr. Zinke, this is indeed a very, very special class, the largest in the history of Stanton College Preparatory School. We would like to apprise you of the fact that 74 out of the 114 graduates in this class have been offered scholarships and loans totaling $3.9 million. Woo! 60 of the graduates have been honored as undergraduate Florida scholars. 41 other graduates have been recognized as prize recipients by the state of Florida. One graduate has been recognized as the school district and regional pride winner in science. 80 class members are graduating with honors. This class has 20 international baccalaureate students, with 16 being IB diploma candidates. This is the largest number ever graduating from Stanton. 5 national merit scholars. Nationally, only 0.5% qualify. We have 4% in our senior class. one National Achievement Scholar for Outstanding Black Students, and one graduate appointed to the United States Naval Academy.
These are just a few of the accomplishments, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give a round of applause to this outstanding class. Dr. Zinke, I'm pleased to certify to you as superintendent of the Duval County Public Schools system that these students are assembled here, have completed all requirements as prescribed by the Duval County School Board and the state of Florida, and they are hereby entitled to receive a high school diploma.
Thank you, Dr. Google. I would say to Dr. Google and to Mr. McIntosh and all of you gathered here this evening that it's great to herald the accomplishments of this class, and I see just one problem with that, however. It may cause the upcoming seniors, this year's juniors, and the classes behind them drop out, feeling that they can't possibly live up to the accomplishments of this class. But I don't think that's going to happen. It didn't happen with this class last year, or previous classes when each one of the senior classes were so heralded for their accomplishments. You have every right to be proud, and we certainly are proud of you. By the authority vested in me by the state of Florida and the Duval County School Board, I now pronounce you graduates of the Duval County School System and confer upon each and every one of you all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. My congratulations to you.
Seniors, please come forward. Would the Honorable Gwen Gibson please come forward to award the diplomas, and our special guests take their place to congratulate our seniors.
Ladies and gentlemen, as a reminder, in respect to these seniors, the 1991 graduates of Stanton College Preparatory School, we ask that you please hold your applause and cheers until the last senior has returned to the audience. Thank you. Lauren Lee Abernathy. Andrea Luttrell Alston. Deshaun Marie Anderson. Jennifer Michelle Anderson, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Kimberly Cornetta Anderson. Jason Vernon Andre. Dan Claiborne Archer Jr. Yolanda Wynette Baggs. Molly Susan Barrow. Kelly Jean Barsham, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate with Diploma. Marshall Dan Belcher. Renanzo Lee Belcher. Laura Prado Belfrano. Paula Prado Belfrano. Jennifer Ann Berman, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Eric Regenden Persona. Mark Othello Fides. Cleanell Alfred Brown Botex, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Cynthia Ann Ford. Bess Wydedra Brockington.
Deardra Carlene Brown. Quajalan Dominique Brown. Joy Sharonda Buckner. Andrea Burnett Bunch. Melissa Dawn Burgess. Tiffany Louise Musard. Michelle Ann Chadwick. David Thomas Clark. Mary April Coleman. Rodriguez Karim Collins. Bradley Basham Comar. Cameron Dion Conley, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Donald Zaid Cowart. Tana Leona Crane. Felicia Nicole Cribb. Ali Alicia Lori Davis. Michelle Lynn Dennison. Joanna Lee Dixon. Samantha Elizabeth Dixon. Alexis Sampson Dominguez. Melody Veronica Douglas. Amandala Fontaine Drummond. Phoebe McPherson Durant. Teclean Megan Ean. Yusuf Latif Evans. Toral Kumlish Thadia. Leela Lovett Felton. Bridget Dolores Freeman. Swetal Naranjan Gandhi. John Stephen Gostenkors Jr. Tara Lee Grant, candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Robin Elaine Hadley. Stephanie Suzanne Hafner. Brian Anthony Harper. Rodney Harris. Jennifer Wyndham Hollinger. Dale Andrew Howell. Jennifer Lynn Boyles. Kelly Francis Johnson, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Delisa Charnell Jones. Marguerite Elizabeth Kennedy. Daniel Patrick Kerr. Ashley Adele King. Jared Noel Kirkman. Chadwick Stephen Knott. Kenneth Warren Krause. George Cody Lazar. Brian Thomas Lee. Travis Xanthi Heidi Lee, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Angelithia Grace Lockley. Alicia Nicole Lowe. Christopher Michael Lumsford. Daniel Lee Lyons, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Tina Nguyen Mason. Jeffrey Barquette Mead. Kathleen Ruth Morrissey. Christopher Michael Bobal. Stephanie Lynn Ogilvy. Patrick Joseph O'Keefe. Elizabeth Ann Olson. Jennifer Erin O'Neill. Catherine Amelia Patton. April Dawn Danielle Peterson. Mm-hmm. Jennifer Louise Phillips. Roger Bryant Creature. Alexander Fongqing Pun. Kelly Lee Ratchford. Angela Marie Reeves. Marissa Kim Riley. Christopher David Rodden. Keith Michael Ryan, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. John Hayden Schmidt. Gina Renee Scott, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Katrina Rochelle Scott. Michael Wayne Segura. Heather Lynn Shook. Erlene Latoche Smith. Stephanie Ann Stevens. Nazra Shafi Subedar, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Brian Cruz Surio. Sarah McBride Tate. Emily Joy Taylor, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Jennifer Yana Tinley. Adam Craig Turba, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Lisa Michelle Tyson. Dagny Lorraine Ulrich, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Jason Allen Ware. Adrian Lamont Washington. Talancia Monique Watson. J. Ivan Weinstein, a candidate for the International Baccalaureate Diploma. Raymond George Wheeldon, Jr. Catherine Elizabeth Wheeler. Antoinette Shalanda Williams. Melissa Antoinette Williams.
long way since we started Stanton. The road was not easy at times, but we stuck it out, and I dare say, tonight proves we have made it. But as it has been pointed out, this is just the beginning for the class of 1991. Now, as individuals, we have great strides yet to make. After tonight, we go our separate ways, but as we go, we take a part of Stanton and each other with us. This song is dedicated to you, my classmates in the class of 1991. I look forward to hearing of you and your accomplishments in the future, because as the starlight burns eternally bright, so does our friendship and memories.
Because you are omnipresent, or because you are omnipotent. And Lord, we especially praise you for your mercy and your grace and your kindness that you have demonstrated towards us. Lord, we pray especially the blessing upon these young men and young ladies tonight that have completed the task of high school education. Lord, we thank you for the gift that you have instilled in them We pray that these gifts will be used for you and for the betterment of society. Lord, as these young men and young ladies leave their homes to pursue further studies and take their place in society, that they would just fulfill your plan and purpose for their lives. Lord, we know there can be no pursuit of true excellence without you. We thank you for these parents who you have given wisdom, who have supported these young people. Lord, as we leave this place, we pray your blessings upon all those who love and fear you. Amen.
Amen.